Hi, welcome to Excel-Dash.com. Today I'm going to share some secrets with respect to the Enter key. Yes, the simple Enter key. There are five uses of this Enter key. One, we all know that when you type something and you press Enter, it goes down. You go to the next row. But if you type something and you press Shift Enter, it goes up. It goes up. It doesn't go down, it goes up. So Shift Enter goes up. So the first use of Enter was simple going down, Shift Enter was going up. Coming to the third use, let's say you have name, mobile number, city of residence, email address. Now you don't want to increase the column width and you don't even want to do wrap text, because in wrap text what happens, if you do wrap text and if you increase the column width by chance, the wrap text goes away. Right, it doesn't, the number NUMBER doesn't stay in the second line like this. So what you want to do is in a way a manual wrap text. So I'm going to just show you a quick example and then we'll do it in that definition. So we say Excel Rush, instead of typing RUSH directly, after Excel I'm going to press an Alt Enter and then type Rush or whatever you want. Alt Enter and then you type whatever you want. Alt Enter whatever you want and then a normal Enter. So that brings up your Alt Enter, a line break, right? So even if you increase the column width, the line breaks don't go, because that is a forceful wrap text using Alt Enter. So here I can go up and press F2 and I can go here and delete this space and press Alt Enter and it stays there. Here as well, I can go here, delete this space and press Alt Enter. Again, I can go here, delete this space and Alt Enter. And of course, this you can adjust however you want. It remains like this. Now, the only problem in Alt Enter is there remains a little space above. So you just have to go to any of these cells, press F2 and Enter, and it removes that extra spacing at the top. Similarly, if you want to see, I can show you in this also. I press F2, Enter. That extra spacing on top got removed. This was the third use of Enter using Alt Enter. So first we learned Enter simple to go down, Shift Enter to go up, and then Alt Enter to go to the next line break. Now we're going to learn Ctrl Enter. Now if I type my name and I want to make it red color font, first I have to press Enter, then go up and then make it red color. Yes or no? To avoid this, something like this, what I can do is I can type my name and directly press Ctrl Enter. That ensures that you remain in the same cell as well as your data is entered. You click on the red color and appears. So Ctrl Enter makes you stay in the same cell by entering the data as well. That was one use of Ctrl Enter, and that was the fourth use of the Enter key. The fifth use of the Enter key is also a Ctrl Enter, which is brilliant. So if you choose a certain cells and you type something, if you type something and you directly press Ctrl Enter, boom, it gets copied to all the cells. I'll repeat myself. Let me undo it. And if you type something and directly press Ctrl Enter, boom, it copies everywhere. As simple as that. Now you have certain amounts, right? You have, let me just zoom out a bit so you see better. You have certain amounts, 120, 45, and then you have a blank, and then 98, and then 65, and then again a blank, and 45, and 1, and blank, and 45. You want these blanks to have a zero. All you have to do is simply using the Ctrl key, select the blanks, type 0 and directly Ctrl Enter, boom, done. So you don't have to waste your time putting 10 and then again 000, or putting 10 and then copy pasting into the blank cells. You simply select the cells first, put a 0 and directly Ctrl Enter. Hope this helps. Thank you for watching.